Hello everyone, Josh here to talk about how to program the Yaesu FT-70D, newest radio from Yaesu on the cheaper side, not the $500 versions, and using their software to program it. The ABMS-10 software should be specific. This is my first video, so please bear with me. Haven't really done any of this before, so just wanted to put that out there. Also, I've been looking for videos on how to program this specific radio, and everything I've seen doesn't explain it. They just talk about how to use the radio and manually input, which is great if you have the time to sit there and do that all day. So I spent some time to figure out how to do it. It's not all that easy. It's quite cumbersome. But I'm going to give it a shot, see if I can explain how to do it here. So if you look here, this is the PDF that you get on either their website or from the CD-ROM that comes with it. I just downloaded everything myself. The CD-ROM wasn't working in my computer. So I went to their website. Here's their website. This is their link to the software itself is right here. As you can see, it's ABMS-10, and it's for the FT-70DR or the FT-70DE. The next thing you want to do after you've downloaded that is download the ABMS-10 PDF. I have it here, and it's from their website. Now, I'm not going to go through step by step of exactly how to do everything, but here's how I did it and how everything works for me. I read through the PDF and, looked at the installation information and then decided that I was going to install the driver manually by right-clicking on the FT-INF file and clicking install. Since I've already done it, I'm not going to do it again. Once the driver was installed, I went into the ABMS-10 and just ran the setup like they show here. It's going to install any of the prereqs and other stuff that's needed to get it working. Then the important part in figuring out how to use this thing is following the exact steps that they say, because it's very confusing. And I'm going to go over it one time. To show how it works. First, remove the battery pack. It even says it right here with it removed. I missed that, I don't know how many times, and things just weren't working right. So we're gonna remove the battery pack and get the supplied cable that came with it right here. And we're gonna plug the supplied cable into the computer. You also need the power supply that comes with it, which I already have cabled up over here and plugged in. And then you're going to follow this exactly what it says. Remove the battery pack, connect the AC adapter, so if you see here, the AC adapter, I don't know if you can tell, but the AC adapter is going to go right there. And so you just put the AC adapter in, and then the front of the screen, it should say EXT-DC, which it does. Then you're going to press and hold the power button right here. So you're going to press and hold it for a second or two, and the transceiver turns on. So now you're in normal operations. Then you're going to remove the power plug that you just put in. Pull it out. Now you're going to connect the USB cable that comes with it. And it just goes, the cable's not long enough. It goes in the slot right above. So once that's connected, You go down to step 5, and you're going to press and hold on the front, and I'm going to show you, unplug it first, on the front right here, that orange button right there is the AMS button. You're going to hold that down while putting the power cord back in. So you hold it down, plug the power cord back in, and it says ADMS. And I can't show you because the cord's not long enough. But it says ADMS just like this on the front screen. Now, at this point, which I've already installed the software and everything, and you should have by now too, open up the ADMS software. Okay, now we're going to do a download. Sorry, get data. Now this is going to tell you exactly what you need to do. And I missed this probably 5 or 6 times trying to figure out why this isn't working. And the big part to remember is, it's going over everything that we just did in steps 1 through 5 and steps 1 through 5 right here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is the exact things that we just did. So don't redo them. We've already done them. Go to step 6. ADMS will display on the... It's already there, right? So step 6, we're good. Step 7 says, click the OK button on the computer screen. Click OK. Now, this, I missed this probably a dozen times. You got to press the band button, which is on the front, to get it... Well, it timed out. That's my fault. So before I press OK, on the front, there's a band button. You've got to press band. It's in error mode right now, so I got to wait a second for it to clear out. All right. So now we're going to go back to get data. You've already done all this. So as soon as you press OK, get ready to press band on the front of the radio. Press band, and it starts, it says TX on the front of it, and now it's receiving the data as you can see on the computer side. So you wait for it to finish, bam, it's done, close this, and there's the data that I have currently in mind. I've only put a couple in there just to make sure I could get it to work. Now, you want to upload, send data, so let's just say you've made a bunch of changes, you've added all of the, you know, repeaters or information that you wanted to add. Again, steps 1 through 6, we're already done, already did all of that, because it says ADMS on the front. So ADMS will display. Yes, it does. So step 7, now it's telling you here to press a button before you do anything else. So you got to find the button that says mode, and I can't see. All right, there's the mode button. Press mode, and on the front it says wait on the front of the radio. So when I press OK, it now changes to receive. So the computer is now sending, and the radio is now receiving. Boom. Done. Now, you're essentially done at this point. You've configured it. You've done everything you need to do. So you can power it off by holding the power button down and disconnect your computer cable and the external power supply and put your battery back in. And at this point, you turn the radio back on and... There's the station that I had programmed on to, our station 1 and station 2. And you can see that those are them by looking here, is the same names. Now we could go over the configs, but everything's fine. So that is essentially the way that I got it to work to where I could program it. Not sure if I did anything other people aren't doing, or if they just missed those same messages that I missed a bunch of times, where you have to click the button on the radio, the band button to do the transmit of the data from the radio to the computer, and Also, this is the mode button here. That button right there is the button that you press to upload to the radio from the computer. Hopefully that works for everybody. Leave me some comments and let me know.